Don Barnes here with episode one of Audio Barnyard. And today we're going to be helping you avoid the VO cow pies and get your VO crop to market in record time, basically growing your business in terms of quality and then having some fun doing it. So I have three primary goals with this whole podcast series. So hey, thanks for joining me for episode one. But I have three things I really want to do here. One is inspire. Two is educate. And then three, have some entertainment in there. I just hate boring. And so today we're going to be talking about a concept called the dual perspective. And I can easily demonstrate this dual perspective thing here. This is the third time I've recorded this episode. The first two are probably fine, but I'm at that stage where it's like, ah, crap, I don't like that. Oh, that's terrible. Oh, shoot. Oh, darn. Yeah, maybe. What? Okay. And at some point, like all artists, we have to just get it out the door and start and then move forward. And I learned this whole dual perspective concept from a gentleman named Gene Stewart, who you're going to hear me talk about incessantly. You'll know that name, Gene Stewart. Unfortunately, he passed probably 15 years ago. And when I was a young guy, I was 14 when I met him to begin with. I thought he was kind of old. I thought wasn't all that smart type thing. Because he was in his 40s. Now I'm almost 60. So yeah, he wasn't that old, but I didn't know that. I was a kid. And Gene had gone to Juilliard. And he was a Motown session player. And I was a young guy learning to play drums. And he would be talking to me about playing drums. But what I didn't know, because I didn't have any perspective, was he actually was teaching me a couple things. One, he was teaching me drums. He'd be showing me exercises. Two, he was teaching me how to teach and how to learn. And he was a master instructor. It was just wild that only later did I realize how lucky I was that I happened to work with him and how many life lessons, because there were many times we weren't talking about drums. We were talking about learning. How do you break that problem down? How do you solve it? He'd be saying this to me. How would you come up with an exercise to make that easier? How would you go about getting that to the point where you don't have to think about it? And he was just, so I hear old Stevie Wonder things. My Sharia Moore always comes to mind for me because he had the bongo part on that. And it's right in the introduction of My Sharia Moore. I'll put a link to that in the podcast notes so you can go for my age challenge friends who don't remember old Stevie Wonder. This would have been, late 70s is my best guess. My Sharia Moore. And so when you hear that song in the link and just check it out, right in the very beginning, you'll hear a bongo, a little drum playing in the background. That's Gene Stewart. So Gene was constantly talking about this thing, but more importantly, he was demonstrating it for me. And this applies dead on to voiceover and any other activity you want to learn as an adult. And here's the summary of it. Number one, whenever we start something new, we're not going to be very good at it. But the dual perspective is, it's okay to be proud for making some progress. That's perspective one. Hey, pat myself on the back. I got a podcast one out the door, my example. Your example, you have voiceover number 37 done, or voiceover number 4,000 or 2,000, whatever your milestone is. Maybe you've done two voiceovers. Maybe you've done 400 or 4,000, whatever it is. Hey, pat yourself on the back. That's super cool. But the other side of it is, I haven't arrived. On the podcast, it's easy for me. I had played thousands of hours of drums as a young guy, and he was constantly, some weeks he'd be beating me up about, you didn't practice enough, or you didn't practice correctly. We'll talk about that in one of the upcoming podcasts. How do you refine a process? Because it's not just repetition. It's not just 10,000 hours. It's what are you doing within those 10,000 hours where you're mastering a subject? So he'd go back and forth from, hey, that was really good. That's pretty amazing. Do you remember a month ago where you couldn't do that particular activity? And then now I'm doing it. And then 6 months later, he'd remind me of how bad I was. Then at the same time, his concept was always, you will never master the drums. You will never master any instrument, was his concept. If you're playing piano, if you're playing drums. And it really turns out later, I was able to realize, gee, if I'm an auto mechanic, if I'm fixing something around the house, if I'm baking or making pizza, I'll never be the ultimate at it. I'll never be up to my potential. And you will never be up to what you're capable of in terms of a voiceover artist, in terms of doing a podcast, in terms of anything we're going to do. We never arrive. And the people that I see succeeding in voiceover, and I've just watched thousands of people over quite a few years here, are the ones that are, they're not getting so down on themselves about every little thing that doesn't work. Because if I really, if I'm my normal self, I'm self-critical, like most of us, and I don't like, you know, this is my third time through this whole thing because I don't like the first two, and I really didn't say I don't like them. I just said, I think I can do it better. I can give you more value. But you know what? This one's going out the door, good, bad, or indifferent, and I'm going to keep refining it. So this is our process. Do something. You can feel good about it for about 15 minutes or 15 days, depending on what we're doing and how long it took to accomplish that task. And then I need to turn around and say, okay, what am I going to do better the next time I podcast? What am I going to do better the next time I'm working a voiceover? What am I going to do better the next time I'm making a pizza? It really doesn't matter. We pat ourselves on the back for what for where we've gotten, and then we look at, well, what's the next step I can take? I should constantly be going, okay, this is better. This is an improvement. But, that's not so good. Or it's not where I could be or I aspire to be. But we're all going to go through it. And frankly, most of us can't listen to something we recorded a year ago without going, wow, is that ever awful at some level? Now, it might be better than some of our peers. I might be better than I was, and I am definitely better than I was 6 months ago or a year ago. But as an adult, we have this whole other process that comes up that makes it hard. And I see so many people getting caught on one end or the other end of this dual perspective. There's a bunch of people out there that already are going, ah, man, I'm awesome. I don't hear any mouth noise in mine. I've never had a customer complain to me, so I must be all that. And maybe you are. Some of us need an outside coach. Matter of fact, I should say, almost everybody needs someone they trust. And I will have an outline. I'll be talking about the mentors. Gene Stewart, as a drum instructor, spent tons of time working with me about how to be a better instructor because he taught me how to teach, how to be a better student. And he always loved that. And for him, the dual perspective was also in, you may learn to teach something. At that point, I was starting to learn to teach drums when I was 17 and 18, 19. He had me teaching at the same time. But you're always a student of everything you're doing. So you might become a good instructor, but you also need to remain a student of it. And that was another one of his dual perspective things. When you teach something, you learn about the process. But at the same time, you better not think that because you're teaching it, that means all of a sudden, you know, your stuff is fantastic. It may be, and you may know a whole lot more than the person you're teaching, but that doesn't mean that you've arrived or you're better than them. And besides, they're going to always, especially as an adult, have some things that they do better than you. They're just not telling you. So don't get all up on yourself about how great you are as an instructor. And certainly don't think that you're better than somebody else because you can teach something or do something, because we all have our blind spots. We all have our issues that we can work on. So let's talk about the voiceover business. It's hyper competitive, and I think it'll only get more so. Why? Well, I'm an admin in the ACX Indie group, and I'm the one that approves everybody coming into the group. And I look at the numbers, and there are some months where we had 300 people. What does that mean? This is just in one group. There are people that don't even know about the group that I'm an admin in. So, and I admin a couple other groups, but and most of you know me from those other groups. But here's the point. The numbers today compared to, say, 2 years ago, the number of people getting in it's going through the roof, and it continues to increase. The rate of increase is going up. More people are starting their voiceover career now than at any time in history, because people have more powerful computers. Microphones are less expensive. There are options for people to get started with, you know, entry-level stuff that does work well enough to get them started. So now you, if you've been around for a couple of years, you're going to have a competitor that you didn't have before. And at first, their performance may just be okay. But you also have people coming into this that also have some broadcast experience, or they did theater. My wife's done, you know, 5,000 voiceovers plus. And she has a theater background and a singing background. And what I see is more and more people coming in, this is their second career, this is their third career, but they already had something in their past where they're not starting where I started, which is, you know, I didn't do very well at some things. They already have a background that makes this much, much easier. So that means you and I are going to be on a constant improvement program. And if we get out of balance with this dual perspective, it's really easy to quit because I'm terrible. Okay. Some of us are Eeyore from Winnie the Pooh. You like that I'm almost 60 and I'm talking about children's metaphors. But Eeyore from Winnie the Pooh just always had the dark, I'm terrible, life is terrible, there's a cloud over my head. And then you have the other people that don't even realize that they're not all that. And they think they're great. And a bunch of us are going, whoa, that's not bad. You know, no one wants to tell them. It's like, if I have bad breath, no one wants to tell me that. It's not, my mom might, there's a few other people that would, one of my kids would. But once you get outside of a select group, my neighbor, he's not going to go, Don's got bad breath. I mean, not to my face, usually, unless we're really good friends and something comes up. I mean, they may hint at it, give me some gum or some things like that, but people just don't tell us our weaknesses. Then I have another podcast on crowdsourcing and the strengths and the weaknesses of it for voiceover pros or people that want to be, because I see all the time people crowdsourcing stuff that they really shouldn't be crowdsourcing or getting the opinion of a bunch of people in some group and how that really hurts them. So you and I are going to have this never-ending tension where today's my worst podcast ever, and I'm going to probably not listen to it again because I'll hate it. Because, too long on this, too short on that, whatever. And then, on the other hand, when I get to podcast number 10, and even on this one, I have to pat myself on the back and say, hey, you got something out there. It's a great start. It's 150 times better than nothing, despite the fact that I'll cringe about all sorts of things, the way I said it, the feel that I gave it, the way I put emphasis on one thing or another. But you know what? I have the same never-ending tension that you will. I can pat myself on the back about it's done or it's out there and I'm moving forward. That's awesome. At the same time, I guarantee you, I've got an outline in front of me and I'm following it and, you know, going on script, off script, that sort of thing. And then I'll listen back to it later and go, wow, gosh, you should have changed the order of this. You should have changed the order of that. Well, that's life. I mean, and I will improve it because I'm sure I'll learn how to outline better. I'm sure I'll learn how to take in information and pass it back to you in a more effective manner over time. But there's no way to be a pro at anything without being bad at it for a while. And this is one of the adult dilemmas. We all have self-awareness, or most of us do. Hopefully we do. And once you're self-aware, you realize things you don't do as well. But contrast that with a child learning something and they don't give a rip. If they're learning to walk, how many times will they fail before they learn to walk? I don't know. But do they go, wow, I'm really uncoordinated and ignorant because I don't walk yet. And look, everyone around me walks. I don't walk yet. Now they just go, whatever. I'll fall down 400 times or 600 times or 4,000 times. I didn't walk until, you ever hear these parents that go, oh, my kid walked at age, I don't know, six, well, I don't know when they walk. We'll just say 2 years. I have five kids and I don't remember when they walk because they're all young adults. No kid cares. And then if you look at this, someone as an adult and you go back and say, hey, I walked when I was, you know, 15 months old. And my brother didn't walk until they were 20 months old. I was 5 months earlier. I don't think it makes a hill of beans difference. What it really makes a difference is a kid is not self-aware and feels like a loser because they fell down 400 times or 600 times or whatever that number is. They keep doing it until they get good at it. The self-awareness is more in that I'm going to succeed at this. Everyone around me has succeeded at it. And I'm not going to worry about what didn't work and I'm going to move forward. So you and I are going to be a coach and a student. You can help other people and you should help other people. At the same time, you will always be a student of this business because we have different aspects. So we can upgrade our tech game. We can upgrade our performance. That'll never, never end. But the self-awareness is always, I feel good about, and I, I, I may not feel great about it, but I certainly need to pat myself on the back and say, good job getting something done. And then, as soon as I'm done with that, look around and say, but what is the next area that I can improve? Because there are aspects of this that are just plain weak compared to where I want to be, compared to where I should be, and compared to my abilities, even if they're not on display right now. And that's the point. We're going to go back and forth between this dual perspective. 2 years from now, you will still be thinking about, okay, hey, what did I do well this last X months? Whether it's 1 month, 6 months. And then what didn't I do so well over the last X months that I'm going to address moving forward? We just won't arrive. So this is it for today. I've got 30 different episodes here that are already outlined. I'm going to continue to refine this. I'm going to pat myself on the back for about 2 minutes and go, okay, that one's done. It's happening. I hope you subscribe to this. I hope you give it some feedback. I hope you listen enough to notice that it improves dramatically. And I'm going to keep them short until I get good at it. Some of these will have guests. Currently, they're going to be once a week. That schedule may change. That's the current plan right now. I haven't even picked a day yet as of this recording. And I have such a performance background that I don't usually get to share because people hire me for doing tech coaching 98% of the time. I don't know, 90% of the time. While I'm working with them, I'm always throwing in performance things because they just don't realize my background is so performance centric in my young adult life and the types of people I was able to work with and their performance background and what I've observed over the years. So they hire me for tech. That's cool. That's cool, cool, cool. But this podcast will give me a chance to also highlight some things that I've learned over the years about your performance and your tech, and we'll have some fun doing it. So the name may change, the dates may change, all sorts of details will continue to get better. What I do promise you is over time, this will be spectacular. And that's kind of a stretch. But I'm saying that, I'm going for it. That's my aspiration, is that I can add value for you. What can I help people with? What can I share that Gene shared with me? How can we make this great for you? I already know this stuff, but articulating it, outlining it, reinforces it for me. That's part of my dual perspective. So I'm doing it to help me and to help you, but to help you first. That's my first thing. So I'll be talking to you over and over again once a week. There are four episodes that are out as of the first episode. I'm putting four out at once and then one every week. And of course, we'll morph and do more. And some of them will be interviews. Some of them will be just this sort of format. But I hope, of course, that you keep the dual perspective in everything you do. Anything you're learning, pat yourself on the back, give yourself a thumbs up, take time to go, wow, I accomplished something. It may not be where you want to be. And then you flip around for a few minutes and you go, okay, let's reevaluate. That was terrible. This was good. I'm going to get a coach. I'm going to have them help me with the parts that are weak. I'm going to have them help me with the parts that are strong. Should I work on my strengths? Should I work on my weaknesses? That really depends on where you're at. We'll talk about that in another session here. Gene Stewart's constantly beating me up on that kind of stuff. So I have an excellent reference. I love sharing with people. Have a fantastic day. This is Don Barnes signing out for Audio Barnyard. And of course, we'll see you on the wires. Bye.